5 shillings every time I go to call upon him.
Yeah.
It weighs heavy on my purse, let me tell you.
Oh, I know. Your health is important to benefit everyone. What you should do is just raise the price of your newspaper.
I couldn't do that. I've thought of it. I've even thought of raising the price of my advertising.
Well, yeah.
But that's why.
I bet you thought of it a lot too, didn't you?
Well, I have the price fixed, if you will, for the first week and the second week.
Yeah.
And almost negotiable, you know.
Right.
I don't put that on the paper,
no.
But
it,
the word gets out.
I'm surprised you're telling me that.
Well, I tell you that because if anyone knows what's going on in the city, it's you.
That's true.
You
know, I keep my ear to the ground.
Keep your ears to the ground.
Yeah. I ask people for information. Sometimes they don't give it to me. There's a woman in a little dress down the way making some nitty notties, and she wouldn't tell me.
Nitty notties.
She wouldn't tell me if that was Mr. Blair or Mr. Pendleton.
Or if he's a beautiful woman to look at.
Putting together a small lock for use on cabinets and chests. We make larger ones for buildings like this and other buildings that may have been through the town here. You also might notice the nails that are used in construction here.
Yet I'm trying to get the milk and butter to decline to the temperature where it won't kill the yeast.
Oh, that's a good idea.
We have the flour here, the yeast here, and we're just letting it cool. It should be cooled down.
Maybe. How are you, dear?
Well, we're fine. We went on a carriage ride. We went on a stable tour. We heard some of Mr. Purdy's opinions.
Did you?
We saw Max Hammer telling lies to Terry Thon.
He was in here telling one to me, so. Right.
Now this lovely young lady, I've not had the pleasure of making the acquaintance of.
Zoe,
what a pleasure. And you get to work with him and he gets to work with you and all these flies too for this company.
The flies are the best company.
Yes, they really are.
Sure. Oh yeah, now she says so. Yeah.
She's our intern and she has to leave a little early today and she wanted to make bread. So this is going to be her bread oven.
All right.
So when it's time to bake, every bit of the fire will be out, so it's the heat of the bricks that'll do our baking for us. But we've got a nice big pile of coals there, so she can circle the coals and then scrape it all out when it goes to gray ash.
How long does it burn before it's ready?
How much baking do you have to do? At this stage, it controls the rest of it. So if you spread this out for 3 hours, you should get 6 hours worth of baking. If you take your time with it and spread it out for 4 hours.
Hey, Mary. Mary.
So did you get your punches?
Yes,
I sure did. Thank you.
Ready on the camera? Hey, Mary.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. We're just admiring this construction.
Hi, these boys done good, you know. Many of the best joke boys join the army.
Yes.
What's left is a lot of apprentices, but I must say they've done very well.
They have, and we can't wait to see it finished.
Oh, it shall be, ma'am, in due time.
Good day to you.
Good day to you.
I, Major James Ennis of the 9th Regiment, and I have been sent here today to enlist men into the Continental Army of America. An army, hoosah, team battle. How we would not hoosah such a fine force. For this army has only existed for a few weeks, my friends, only for no more than 5 months, and already she has seized Fort Ticonderoga, liberated the hinterland of Massachusetts, and driven the red troops out of Boston forever!
Thank you.